Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the family Bixaceae. The family Bixaceae, it is one of the dicot family. This family is characterized by presence of red sap. Basically, the stem which is observed in this family is red in color. While the flowers which are observed in this family, they are either yellow or red in color. So this family is known as an achiote family. The meaning of achiote is they show presence of red sap or red color pigments. That's why this family is known as achiote family. Due to the presence of red sap, this family is also known as a lipstick family. So today we are going to discuss about the family Bixaceae in detail. So let's start. See that these are the big flowers of the family Bixaceae. So first we see the classification of family Bixaceae. So the family Bixaceae, it belongs to kingdom Plantae because they are the chlorophyll bearing plants. It belongs to subkingdom Rachiophytes because they are the vascular plants. The xylem and phloem which are observed in the plants, they are very well developed. Then this family belongs to division Angiosperms. And the characters for Angiosperms are they show presence of double fertilization. The ovules are enclosed in ovary wall. Then they belong to subdivision eudicots. What is the meaning of eudicots? Whenever we are going to germinate the seeds of this plant, they will produce two leaves at time. So that plants we categorize as an eudicots. Then they belong to class Rosettes. So if we observe the flowers which are observed under this family, so they are somewhat big flowers. Then according to new classification system, this family Bixaceae, it belongs to order Malvels. According to the earlier classification systems, this family, it is included under the order Violes. But according to current classification, this family, it is included under the order Malvels. And the family is Bixaceae. So this is the overall classification of the family Bixaceae. Now see about the distribution of this family. See that most of the members which are belonging to this family, they grows on tropical, subtropical and temperate regions of the world. According to the plant list, this family shows a presence of 3 genera and total of about 97 species. Out of that 97 species, only the 23 species are accepted one. So let's see what are the 3 genera which are included under this family. So the first genera, that is the Bixa. See that whatever the flower which are going which you are going to observe here, this is the flower of Bixa. Then Coccolospermum. Basically in earlier system, the Amyroxia, it is also one of the genera which is included under this family. But now it is concluded that the Amyroxia, it is the synonym of the genus Coccolospermum. This genus shows presence of total of about 13 species. And the last genera which is observed under this family Bixaceae is Digodendron, which shows presence of a single species. So let's see that. See, this is the Bixa family. These are the flowers of Bixa, genus Bixa. And there are total of 5 species of this Bixa, that is Bixa arborea, then Bixa excellensa, Bixa aurelana, then Bixa platycarpa, and Bixa urocorena. So these are these 5 species which are included under the genus Bixa. Then see that these are the 13 species which are included under Clocalosperma. These are total 13 species which are included under this Clocalosperma genera. Then see that this is the third genus which is included under this family, that is the Digodendron humberti. See that this is one of the tree species. And these are the flowers of Digodendron species. So now moving towards the introduction of family. See that Bixaceae, it is some of small family because it shows the presence of total of about 3 genera and nearly about 23 species. Basically there are 92 species, but only 23 species they are accepted one. So it is one of the small family which shows the presence of tree and shrubby members. So one of the characteristic feature of this family is that it shows the presence of red sap. This family, it is one of the dicot family, and that dicot family, it is also called as an achiote family. And already I have told you why this family is called as an achiote family. So because of its reddish sap. So see that according to the Cornquist system of classification, basically this family, it is included under the order Viales. But now this family, it is included under the order Malvels. So now moving towards next, that is the general characteristic features of this family. So under the general characteristic features, we have to study the vegetative characters and reproductive characters. So under the vegetative characters, we have to study the habit of this family, root system, stem, and the leaves of the family. So let's we start from its habit. So see that most of the members which are belonging to this family, they are either tree or shrub species. So this is the characteristic feature of this family, that is the family Bixaceae members, they are either tree or shrub species. Then about the root system, see that it is one of the dicot family. So the root system which is observed here, that is the taproot system. Then the stem which is observed under this family, so see that the stem, basically the members in this family, they are either tree species or the shrub species. So the stem which is observed under this family, it is hard, woody, erect, cylindrical, branched, and which produces red latex. Okay. So if we are going to describe the stem of the tree species, then we have to describe it as the stem is hard, woody, erect, branched, and produces the red latex. For the shrubby species, see that the stem is hard, somewhat it is herbaceous, erect, it is also branched and produces the red latex or have the red sap. So this is the description of stem which is observed in the family Bixaceae. So if you observe the leaves which are present under this family, so see that somewhat the leaves are large. See that the leaves are stipulate. If you observe the stalk of the leaves, the stalk of leaf, it is very large. So this family or the leaves of this family, they show presence of long petiole, and that petiole, it is hairy. So this is one of the distinguishing character of this family. Then the leaves, if you observe here, the leaves are simple. They show presence of alternate phyllotaxy. Then, in some of the cases, in some of the genera, the leaves are palmately compound, or you can say that they are palmately nerved. They show presence of entire margins. See here, the margins are entire. If you observe the leaf neatly, see that the base is broad, the apex is acute, and they show presence of reticulate venation. Okay, so these are the characters of the leaves. That is, the leaves are stipulate. They show presence of long petiole. Petiole is hairy. Presence of simple leaves. Alternate phyllotaxy. They are palmately nerved. Entire margins. The leaves are broad at base, acute at apex, and shows presence of reticulate venation. See that the variations which are observed in the family Bixaceae. See that here the leaves are simple. See here the leaves are palmately compound. See here the leaves are lobed one. So these are some variations which are observed under the family Bixaceae. Then moving towards next character, that is the reproductive characters. And under the reproductive characters, we have to study the type of inflorescence, flowers, calyx, corolla. If the calyx and corolla is absent, then about the perianth, androecium, gynoecium, fruit, type of seed. That characters we have to study under the reproductive characters. So first we start from the inflorescence. So family Bixaceae, it is characterized by presence of a panicle type of inflorescence. So see that if you observe this inflorescence, it is a panicle type of inflorescence. And basically, it is present at the terminal side. That's why the inflorescence is terminal panicle type of inflorescence. Then about the flowers, see that if you observe the flowers which are present under this family, so the flowers, they are somewhat large. Then the flowers are pedicellate, bisexual, actinomorphic, hypogynous. The meaning of hypogynous is the perianth, androecium, gynoecium, or androecium, they are originating from the base of ovary. That's why the flowers are hypogynous. Then the flowers are pentamerous, means the perianth, then the androecium and gynoecium, they are present in the multiple of 5. Basically, the flowers which are observed under this family, they are either white, pink, yellow, or red. So these are the variations of the flowers which are observed under this family. The flowers are either white, pink, yellow, or red. Then moving towards calyx. See here. So the sepals which are present here, they are in number 5. Then see here, these are the sepals. So the sepals are free, that's why they show presence of polysepalous condition. Then if you observe the phyllotaxy, then they show presence of imbricate aestivation. If you observe the aestivation here, so the aestivation is imbricate. Then this sepals or this calyx show the presence of a biglandular, or they show presence of glands at the base. See here, they show presence of glands at the base. Then about the corolla, see here that the petals are in number 5. If you observe here, the petals are free. That's why they show presence of polypetalous condition. If you observe here neatly, you are able to see the aestivation is imbricate. That is one petal, it is completely inside. One petal, it is completely outside. And the remaining three, they are alternate with each other. Otherwise, some of the members, they show presence of twisted aestivation. Then moving towards next, that is the androecium. So if you observe the flowers which are observed under this family, so stamens, they are numerous. You are unable to count that. So the stamens, they are many, free, bilocular. And basically, if you observe the structure of the anther, so the anthers are horseshoe shaped. So this is one of the characteristic feature of this family. Okay, the diagnostic feature of that family is that if you observe the anthers, so anthers are horseshoe shaped. Okay. Then about the gynoecium, see here. This is the gynoecium. So the carpels, they are 2 to 4. Then it is united. In some of the genera, the ovary, it is unilocular. Then the ovary is superior and it shows the presence of parietal placentation. The placentation which is observed under this family, it is the parietal placentation. So this is about the gynoecium. The number of carpels, they are in between 2 to 4. They are united to form a superior unilocular ovary and shows a presence of parietal placentation. Then see that the type of fruits which are observed under this family. So see that these are the bixa fruit. So that fruits we called it as a locucidal capsule. And if you observe here, see that the seed shows presence of hairs. And the seeds which are observed here, they are also red in color. See here. The seeds, they show fleshy red testa and the seeds are endospermic one. So see that they are, whenever the fruit, it will get dry. So you are able to see the seeds which are red in color. So see that once again we are going to discuss about what are the distinguishing characters of this family. So we start from its habit. So most of the members belonging to this family, they are either shrub or tree species. The next character about, or next distinguishing character about this family is about the stem. So the stem, it is basically red. Red in color, they show presence of red, red sap. Then the stem, it is hard, woody, erect, cylindrical and branched one. About the leaves, so the leaves are simple, stipulate. They show presence of long petiole and the petiole is hairy. This is also distinguishing character. Then the leaves, they show presence of entire margins. The leaves are simple. In some of the genera, they are palmately compound or they show presence of lobed structures. Then next one, that is the inflorescence. So inflorescence which is observed under this family, it is the type of inflorescence which is observed under this family. It is terminal panicle type of inflorescence is observed. Then next about the flowers. So flowers, they are somewhat big. They show presence of, the flower is complete, bisexual, pedicellate, actinomorphic and hypogynous. So these are the characters of flowers. Then about the calyx. So calyx, they are generally present in number 5. Then they are free or fused. Then they show presence of volvate or imbricate aestivation. Then about the corolla, their number is also 5. So they are free, they are polypetalous, they show presence of either imbricate or twisted aestivation. Then about the androecium, so androecium which are observed under this family, they are numerous in number. And the main character of this one, that is the anthers, they are horseshoe shaped. Then about the gynoecium, the number of gynoecium is in between 2 to 4. And they get united to form a unilocular ovary. The ovary is superior and they show presence of parietal placentation. Then the type of fruit which is observed under this family, that is the locucidal capsule type of fruit which is observed under this family. And see that the seed shows presence of red testa. So these all are the distinguishing characters which are belonging to the family Bixaceae. So remember about this family, the family Bixaceae, it is one of the Achiote family, and the meaning of that is they show presence of red latex or red sap. That's why they are known as an Achiote or an lipstick family. And these are the distinguishing characters of this family. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.